South side in this bitch like a tampon. Dixon blocked the big sack, don't want it if it's stepped on. $1,000 belt on, holy Gucci jeans up. Niggas playing dirty, wet them up, that's how we clean up. Mama's only son, her last name, gotta protect it. Niggas don't like me, but they still gotta respect it. Codeine flow, yeah, RIP Mo. And my boy Hawaka Heard, we gon' hold you down, bro, yeah. I just came down, candy paint dripping slow. Elbows poking out like I'm playing in the post. Please let them know, they don't want it with Godzilla. Can't walk in these shoes, they're expensive, Margilla. Sunny South Side, this is our side, baby. Let me give you a tour of the South Side, baby. When you come from Oak Cliff over the bridge to see MLK, a bunch of liquor stores, they be open like every day. To the left of you is Park Road, to the right you got 3510. If you don't know, nobody can get in. Passport's the 80, you know it's jumping, that's the car wash. So Sunday look like Vegas, police they be haters. Make a right on Malcolm X, you pass the packing house next. Now you in 4 Deuce, where niggas straight flex. Then you cross over Pine, that's where them 4-4 boys at. Then pass Little Road, that's where them youngsters make noise at. You at the light that's Hatcher, in front of you that's Lincoln High School. Home of the Tigers, where them boys don't lose. Make a right on Hatcher, left on Brush Street. Now you in Bucktown, Texas, nothing south for shit sweet. They towed down the projects, Rose Terrace, they're legendary. Where young niggas play the corners like secondaries. Go under the bridge, that's Turner Courts. They towed them down too, but they still hold down the fort. Headed back to Hatcher, make a right pass so bizarre. Where everybody know everybody, you feel like a star. You can go left on Second, that's Lego Park. They car wash jump too, but just be careful after the door. You make a right on Second, past Percy Middle School. Shit, the whole Dallas know that bitch was a fool. You keep going, make a left in my hood, that's Dixon. The first neighborhood in Dallas that was crippin'. But we ain't set trippin', one family, one team. Keep going on Dixon and make a left on Sain. Past churches and Williams, be careful if you smart. You gon' see PC Cobb, the next is the front part. For a few weeks, the whole city come there. Grambling PV, we eat good and families have fun there. You pass Grand back down Martin Luther, that's Madison High. Where all they do is win, and that's no lie. We just roll through South Dallas, through these speakers. Where them niggas ball hard and never sit in the bleachers. Don't forget you need music, hit up in the connection. And when it comes to bad women, we got air complexion. It's South Dallas, baby, you know we got pride. Everywhere I go, they know I'm still repping the South Side. I love the Triple D in South Dallas forever. No matter where you from, we gon' stick together. Because it's South Side, South Side, yeah. South Side, South Side, you know I'm riding for the South Side. South Side, yeah. South Side, South Side, what up, what up? Fun time text, I see y'all, man. What's up, Turner Court, huh? 4 Deuce, what? 44, Malcolm X, I'm Oakland boy. Where y'all at, nigga? 187 Park Road, 3510. Yeah, what? Uh-oh. You know we do it for the South one time, Lego Park. Huh? And you know I can't forget my block, Dixon Circuit in the building. Nigga, this is South Dallas, Texas.
Yes, sir. Make sure my motherfucking mic is on real quick, man. Microphone check. All right, let me take my handsome face off of here first. Let me see. Mic check, mic check. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, look, man, real quick, man. Enjoy life, smile every day. That is a mantra that was coined by the late great comedian, legend, Roy Lee Pate, straight out of Dallas, Texas, South Dallas, Texas, to be exact. So much love to him, to his family, and to his people. Sometimes it can be very hard to smile. You know, Pac said it's going to be some shit that you're going to have to smile through. Gonna be some bullshit that you're gonna have to smile through, you know what I'm saying? And hold on real quick, man. Oh yeah, if you want to, you know, you want to get a hat, man, y'all holler at me, man. Get your nice little, you know, the merch is out. But yeah, but it's gonna be some bullshit that you're gonna have to smile through. And you think about enjoy life, smile every day. I really think sometimes we take for granted how many times that we smile per day. You know, if you ever had a baby or been around a baby, you know, they smile. You know, they're the best when they smile. And also, as you know, I'll talk a lot about mental health and things of that nature. And smiling is very important. You know what I'm saying? And I just got to, you know, I got to have my little notes, my little research and whatnot about smiling and mental health and how it all correlates. And also my own opinions on what Roy Lee's mantra, enjoy life, smile every day, means to me personally. But nonetheless, there is a strong connection between smiling and mental health, right? Smiling can help you improve your mood and reduce stress levels. And when you smile, your brain releases endorphins, which are basically a natural feel-good chemical. Endorphins are natural feel-good chemicals that can boost your mood or reduce feelings of pain and stress, right? Smiling can also improve social connections and relationships, which are important for mental health. When you smile at others, they are more likely to smile back. And this can create a positive feedback loop that enhances feelings of happiness and social connectedness. Me personally, one of the first things that I see on a person, you know what I'm saying? Like, I like to go have fun. I'm an overthinker, so sometimes I can really sit and I'll be in the zone. You know what I'm saying? Like, it don't really matter wherever I go. I'll just be in the zone. I'll be so focused to where I can tell myself to say, hey, bro, you gotta loosen up a little bit. You know what I'm saying? My children, they help me smile a whole lot because they are brilliant and they just like me. You know what I'm saying? They serious, but they can get goofy too. And I like to have fun. Even when I'm attracted to beautiful women with a beautiful smile. Like, that's the first thing I noticed. Like, besides, like, the body, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, ain't nothing wrong with a little, you know, body or whatever body you got. But first thing I'm going to notice is your smile. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn, she got a pretty-ass smile. She got some pretty-ass eyes. You know what I'm saying? Then I'm going to look at everything else. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to say, oh, she got that ass. You know what I'm saying? Oh, shit, she got some pretty-ass feet. Her pinky toe prettier than a bitch. You know what I'm saying? Before I even get to looking at everything else, I'm going to look at her smile. Like, damn, she got a beautiful smile. If I say, hey, you know, hey, how you doing? You know what I'm saying? She said, I'm doing, you know what I'm saying? That just does something to me. You know what I'm saying? Personally. You know what I'm saying? Because that's just something I like to do. You know what I'm saying? I never have a problem. I will never see too many beautiful black women smile. That's something I can literally watch all day, every day. You know what I'm saying? So whenever I see a beautiful black woman, I say, hey, you know what I'm saying? Hey, how you doing? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Hey. Hey, how you doing? You know what I'm saying? And I get a little smile back. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm a conversationalist, so I like to get in conversations. And, hey, if I can make you smile, you know what I'm saying? You finish the sentence. But anyway, but on the other hand, people who experience depression or other mental health conditions may find it difficult to smile or experience pleasure in general. This can also be a symptom of the condition that may require professional help to address. You know what I'm saying? A lot of folks have a tough time smiling. They might have had a hard life or a hard day, hard consecutive days, hard, you know what I'm saying? You know, just hard things people go through. So they might have like a personal meme mug. They just be like, you know, so you ever say hi to somebody, like, hey, how you doing? They'd be like, as you walk past, I'd be like, God damn, man, shit. You know what I'm saying? You want a box? You know what I'm saying? God damn, you know what I'm saying? And I have to remind myself not to take it personal because I don't know what that person is going through, but they may have heard me. They just might not have, you know, have had a good day. They may be pissed off or something like that. Everybody ain't going to smile all the time. Everybody will be cheesing and pleasing it. All that shit. And sometimes when you grow up in a environment like I grew up in South Dallas, you might not get no smiles from a lot of people. You know what I'm saying? That's just being frank. So depending on where you're from, your area, your state, your hood, wherever you're from, you might not get no smiles from nobody. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You just lock them up. It might not. You know what I'm saying? It may not be letting the snot out. You know what I'm saying? My bad. Nigga parched. But it may not be nothing to smile about. So don't take it personal. But nonetheless, if you can make somebody smile, there's nothing wrong with, you know, at least trying, you know. Let me see. Where do I want to go with this? I'm going to go to a slight commercial break. Also, while I got you right here, shout out to the apple juice. I got this here from Aldi's, so 100%. Put that back down. It's free advertising for them niggas. The apple juice fire though. But make sure you pay attention to what's at the bottom of the screen. You know what I'm saying? There are people that I fuck with, family, friends, and whatnot. Also, if you are in Plano, Texas. All right, you are in Plano, Texas. You might want to, if you're looking for some lunch, you in the area, you're like, damn, I'm hungry. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Excuse me. Go to Walmart, all right? Go to the Ghost Kitchen, all right? Make sure you, when you go to the Ghost Kitchen, make sure that you hit the button of Scrumptious Fried Pies. Man, Scrumptious Fried Pies go hard. You know what I'm saying? Black owned business, you know what I'm saying? I know these people personally. They are my family. Shout out to my cousin Tiff, you know what I'm saying? They're doing their thing out there. Mother and daughter owned business. Fried pies, pop pimping, you know what I'm saying? Go hit up their Instagram, Facebook, everything, you know what I'm saying? But most of all, you can find their pies right in Plano, Texas, Walmarts that have Ghost Kitchen, all right? Ghost Kitchens. So whenever you have Ghost Kitchen, go there, get them scrumptious fried pies, and goddamn me, pie pimping. You know what I'm saying? And once you bite into the pie, you officially been pimped, straight like that. You know what I'm saying? You officially been pimped. You feel me? Also, take some time out to check out a lot of my videos. Also, if you hear these beats right now, it's these beats are produced by Rashad a Fool. He's produced tracks for Pink Pressure, tracks for, I think he just dropped a track from Gunna Meezy that he produced. So you guys want to look out for Rashad a Fool, man. He's buzzing out here. You know, so can't folk out here bubbling out here, man. Go look at his YouTube page. It's down there right below these little lines. It's right down there. Also, make sure you follow Scruffzona on IG and all music platforms. Follow Asize on Facebook. His new album, Intricate Feelings, excuse me, Intricate Feelings has dropped. All right, it has dropped. So that is out right now. Listen to that. It's very thought provoking, you know what I'm saying? And it's just a good album, it's just great music, you know what I'm saying? Also, if you need something move from point A to B and back to A, man, go hit up my big bro, Sean Brooks at Everyday Services, right down below. It's moving right there, you know what I'm saying? Stay true to the hill, man. Hey, I'm going off the dome, so that's why it's a little bit off kilter, but I just felt the need to make this because sometimes we just need to smile, man. Like, we go through so much shit as individuals. Like, I know I've been through a lot of shit, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes people get me misconstrued because a lot of my humor, it comes from a very dark place. Not saying that my humor is dark, but it comes from a dark place. Rather, I'm trying to make myself feel better because this shit is tough out here. You know what I'm saying? It's very, very rough out here. And sometimes you may find yourself in a place where you kind of find it hard to be happy about shit, hard to smile, or just hard to just be positive and stay positive. You know what I'm saying? It might be people around you. You know what I'm saying? It might be some of the company that you keep that's not making you feel as happy as you're supposed to goddamn you feel. You know what I'm saying? Supposed to be happy in this bitch. You know what I'm saying? But you are in the house mad. Holding your head and all that shit, man. Pick your head up. You know what I'm saying? Chest out. Head up. You know what I'm saying? And try to find something that's going to make you smile. Make sure you associate your people. Make sure you associate yourself with people that are going to make you smile. For me personally, I know I can always get a smile out of my big brother. You know what I'm saying? I know I can always get a smile out of a few of my friends or my children. You know what I'm saying? That is something I can always, you know, I know that's there. It's always going to be some laughter. You know what I'm saying? Because, hey, man, you got to laugh, man. And you really have to enjoy your life. You can't worry about what everybody else is saying here and there. You know, and sometimes that can be difficult. I know for me personally, because I am an overthinker, like I said earlier, I can sit and I can, what's the word I want to use? I can ruminate on certain things that don't necessarily have no weight to them, but just sitting like, damn, man, I wonder why this, I wonder why that. And I always wonder why, you know what I'm saying? And sometimes there is no why. I think a lot of times we kind of get caught up in trying to find the absolute in a world where there's not many like absolutes, you know what I'm saying? Krishnamurti said, man, truth is a pathless land. So however you get to the truth, however you find it, you know what I'm saying? There's not one right way, you know what I'm saying, to find it. You just kind of got to keep going and keep striving and keep pressing on and really, you know, this nigga LeBron went off the backboard on niggas. But anyway, whatever you want to press your line about, like for me, for instance, this TRILLPILL shit, I'm serious about it. And I press about it all the time, you know what I'm saying? And I have to teach myself to stop stressing over what I expected. You know, I know, like, I might be, you know, doing some great shit, but it may not be getting noticed or it may not be getting the numbers that I wanted to get. You know what I'm saying? And that's fine. I have to coach myself, like, hey, you in this shit for the long run, right? The fuck you rushing for? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like Nip said, man, she was a marathon, man. So plant your fucking flag in the ground and just keep grinding, 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 grinding. Put them 10,000 hours in, and then shit, see what you come up with. You never know, man. You know what I'm saying? You never know. So although it may not seem like you're doing something, whatever it is, whether it's content creation, whether you're working towards a goal in your life, it may not seem like you're not getting anywhere, but don't give up. You know what I'm saying? I guarantee you, you are a lot closer than you think you are. You feel what I'm saying? So, without further ado, like I said, it's going to be a long, long video, man. I'm going to play a few clips from Roy Lee. You know what I'm saying? If you don't know who he is, I'm going to, you know, give you a slight introduction to him. And then you go and you follow up, because this was a very dope person that really left too early. You know what I'm saying? He left too early, man. Really, really early, man. A little too early, man. Because he was on his way. His, man. Anyway. I mean, let me say this too, man. It's tough when we lose guys that you knew they were going to have a worldly impact because of who they were. You know what I'm saying? If you grew up in South Dallas or anywhere around where Arolee was, you knew what type of energy that he brought around. You know what I'm saying? He was naturally, he was a natural. He didn't have to try being funny. He was a natural. The way he talked, the way he delivered his messages, and the way he just, he had a great way of making the best out of life as it is, you know what I'm saying? Like, without taking any, you know what I'm saying? Without trying to, like, overdo it. It's like, well, shit, if I got this shit, I'm gonna make something out of this. Fuck it. You know what I'm saying? That's why his videos were so relatable, because it was relatable circumstances. So I'm gonna play a few videos and go to a couple of music videos, and I'm gonna make my little closing statements. I'm gonna be out of here real quick. Mr. TRILLPILL, make sure you like, share, and subscribe to the TRILLPILL YouTube page. Go follow me on Instagram, Twitter, all that good shit. I get to all that shit later, though. Don't worry about it.
Hey, yeah, how you doing?
Hey,
Riley,
you got approved?
Hey, yeah, man. Last time I got denied, you hear me? Mm-hmm. When more people tripping, they approved me, man. So I got $80, man. On the school, man, I'm happy than a bitch, man. It's hot in the bitch, but I got approved, man. Well, I'm happy than a motherfucker, man. I got $80, so what I'm finna do is.
What you gonna do with your
$80? I don't know. I'm finna do me. Say, I'm finna do me, cause see, man, them kids, I had them kids yesterday. You hear me? So this 80, I'm finna shoot dice with 20. Go get me some Williams. Oh, yeah, I'm kicking it, man. I'm kicking it. Hey, yo, I'm happy, man.
Yesterday, so what you ain't gonna spend
this your soda? Stuff? This your soda?
Yeah.
I'm finna go ahead and get a couple eyes, man. Say, I'm happy to be, man. All right,
early.
Yeah, I gotta prove.
All right, fool.
Shit.
Say, yeah. Turn it down real quick. For the beat a nigga at, where you at?
Shit, over there on Lake June, the Masters.
Okay. I'm for the beat this nigga at. What happened?
Shit, okay. So we sitting outside, you know, at the green box. And this nigga just walk up and was calling us out our names, calling us bitches and shit, because then nobody want to fuck with him. Just
what?
Real disrespectful. Then the nigga Shoes was talking and shit.
What?
Hell yeah. So he was talking that shit. And I was like, shit, I got somebody for
what
you.
What y'all do, like, though?
We were just chilling on it, you know, enjoying life. Sitting up there at the green box.
Yeah, just he just chilling, fucking smoking. With y'all.
Yeah, one.
Did he hit y'all?
Now he ain't hit us.
Okay, but why y'all want me to go over and beat him up then, man?
Because he called us a bitch, and I had already told him I had somebody for him.
Who for him?
You.
No, I ain't got nothing, man.
No.
Y'all ain't never really seen me fight. But y'all seen me argue. I can argue the shit out of a nigga.
We heard you was back there, like. That's why we called you.
Nah, ain't about it, man. I'm trying to enjoy life. I got so much going on. I ain't trying to go to loose theory or nothing. I ain't trying to go to gym or nothing.
So, you can't.
How y'all, do you got a gun?
We don't know.
Y'all don't know. See, that's what I'm saying. Y'all need to watch pockets. Y'all need to watch shit.
Right. All he said was get a nigga. So we called you.
Nah, okay, where y'all kin, other kin folks? I'm y'all other kin. I'm down the line kin folks.
That's what.
Hey, dog, that shit funny as hell, man. Y'all know what it is, Mr. TRILLPILL, man. Quick commercial break and get right back to my closing statements, and then we'll be right out of here, man. Much love to y'all, man. God bless, man. Let's go.
Street classics, fuck nigga.
We only doing it strictly for the streets.
Neighborhood crew, I gotta tell you that my struggle weekend. I got some racks up in the middle, showing love to Nipsey. Police signs, mama crying, it's a lot in my city.
Oh God.
Met some OGs in the west side, you don't know the feeling. You don't know the feeling when they showing envy, trying to knock the flame out of the image. Hey, and I gotta put a wall up, cause I know these haters trying to push against me. Hey, They love the way that I move, the way that I talk. They fuck with the dripping, yeah. Fuck it, baby, y'all rolling the street with my dog, and you know they be creeping, yeah. Cut of your frames on me, yeah. Cut of your frames can't see me, yeah. Butterfly those big wings, yeah. Chopping with the mic, make a scene, yeah. I was down in the dirt too deep. I done did a lot of shit with these streets, yeah. Gotta run up a check at the lead, yeah. I ain't arguing with a hoe with big feet, yeah. I caught the best of weed, yeah. The fashion, the drip, you need, yeah. You niggas ain't fucking with me, ay. You niggas ain't fucking with me, ay. I ain't never ever posting no bag, but I been running up a check too fast, boys. Put them all in the trash bag, so another pack came in, flip, it's gone. OG got pack, got me higher than a drone. Streets ain't safe, that's why I'm always at home. Keep up the pace if you want a new home. Now I'm at the verge, about to get a new home. Talking all that shit, purge running in your home. Precise with the chopper, quit the aim at your dome. Bag came in, gotta buy a new phone. These hoes won't leave me alone. Neighborhood crew, I gotta tell you that my struggle weekend. I got some racks up in the middle, showing love to nips, eh. Police signs, mama crying, it's a lot in my city. Met some OGs in the west side, you don't know the feeling. You don't know the feeling when they showing envy, trying to knock the flame out of the image, ay. And I gotta put a wall up, cause I know they haters trying to push against me, ay. They love the way that I move, the way that I talk, they fuck with the dripping, yeah. Fuck it, baby, I roll in the street with my dog, and you know they be creeping, yeah.
Christian Dior, and I still play with the game, we gon' stop. Fuck this, you know what I roll. Like his head off his neck, he be down. I'ma slide in the cattle, you know. We gon' wear the nigga up like a jet ski. We gon' take a nigga down if you touch me. And I'm being G5, don't play with me. I scared them nigga block, everything freeze. Man, kill my dog, let him rest in peace. Wonder when I'm gone, y'all gon' remember me. I'm still in the jungle with them down mates. I was down on my ass, I ain't have faith. Let a fuck nigga play, we clean his face. I leave a nigga dead on any state. From the clip with the Drake, we touch the heart of the chopper, touch the threes, knock your nigga head straight. I was calling with the dollar, you know nothing but a killing and robbing. I'm the goat, and you niggas till I babbin' and robbin'. Y'all ride together, it's okay, cause y'all gon' think I'm the devil. But get it together, you know we been sliding anywhere. Don't be special when your dog die and get out of the clap, cause it's a rap when you find out where your motherfucking house, y'all.
Neighborhood crew, I gotta tell you that my struggle weekend. I got some racks up in the middle, showing love to nips, eh. Police signs, mama crying, it's a lot in my city. Oh God. Met some OGs in the west side, you don't know the feeling. You don't know the feeling when they showing envy, trying to knock the flame out of the image, ay. And I gotta put a wall up, cause I know they haters trying to push against me, ay. They love the way that I move, the way that I talk, they fuck with the dripping, yeah. Fuck it, baby, I roll in the street with my dog, and you know they be creeping, yeah.
For sure, man. That was Neighborhood CEO, man. I don't know where them young niggas at, man. But if you know where them young niggas at, man, come hit me up, man. I always like that song. That song came out a few years ago. But shout out to everybody in South Dallas. Man. Everything I played today is from South Dallas. Everything I'm going to play is from South Dallas. Besides like a couple of songs at the end. I'm starting out, you know, to represent my neighborhood, man. Shout out to everybody in Lego Park, man. Shout out to everybody in every area of South Dallas, man, from 4-4 to 4-Deuce to Park Road to Dixon to Bonton to Lego, back on up, man. And hey, man, it's a beautiful thing to be from South Dallas, and I think that was also they also played a piece in Roy's humor, right? Because of how he was, you know what I'm saying? Because how he is, like, that's kind of what you get from being a product of South Dallas. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be raw. You know what I'm saying? For good or for worse. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be pure, undulterated. You know what I'm saying? Type shit. At the same time, man, just that part of the city is so isolated. That's why they call it the island. To where, you know, we growing up, you know what I'm saying? This shit really do feel like a bowl we gotta make it out of. And some do and some don't. So being that he was one of the ones who made it out, and he was from the land, he was from the island, it was different to see somebody. It's always like, y'all know how I feel when you see somebody from your neighborhood or from your city do something. You know what I'm saying? And then that person be from your neighborhood too. You know what I'm saying? Somebody that you seen a couple times. You know what I'm saying? They're like, oh shit, I remember Buddy. You know what I'm saying? And then you see him doing big shit, and it's like, damn. You know what I'm saying? It gives you like a sense of pride. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn, that's what's up. It's also very inspiring, and that inspires me a whole lot. You know, like I said before, enjoy life, smile every day, fuck what a hater got to say. That's a mantra that I know I know a lot of us from that area and from the city and from people who just knew about Roy Lee, we kind of carry that mantra because it helps us throughout our day. You know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna give you a little bit, maybe, let me see. About five things, five ways smiling can help mental health in several ways. Number one, like I said earlier, it releases endorphins. Smiling triggers the release of endorphins, which are a natural mood boosting chemical. These chemicals help you reduce the feelings of stress, anxiety, and depression, like I read before. Also, it reduces stress. Smiling can help reduce cortisol. All right. Cortisol is a hormone that is associated with stress, and by reducing cortisol levels, smiling can help you lower your stress levels and promote a sense of calmness. All right. Number three, it also enhances social connections. When you smile, you are more likely to be perceived as friendly and approachable, which can help enhance social connections. Social support is important for mental health, and smiling can help strengthen relationships with others. Number four, improves mood. Smiling can help you improve your mood by sending signals to your brain that you are happy. This may and can help counteract negative emotions and also promote feelings of well-being. Number five, most importantly to me in particular, is that it boosts self-esteem, you know. When you smile, you may feel more confident, more positive about yourself, you know. This can help boost your self-esteem and also promote a more, a more positive self-image. And overall, smiling can be a simple yet effective way to promote mental health and well-being. Incorporating smiling into your daily routine, even if it's a little corny. It's some corny shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it don't matter what you look at, something be like, God damn. Or me personally, say I pull up at the grocery store. Well, I pull up anywhere, right? I'll sit in the car. Hold up. I'll sit in the car and roast the shit out of nigga walking in. This nigga over here, boy, nigga. Boy, nigga look like goddamn me, Waldo. You know what I'm saying? Big pants, little shoes wearing ass nigga. You know what I'm saying? Big pants, little shirt, big hat wearing ass nigga. You know what I'm saying? This nigga over here. You know what I'm saying? Sitting just roast shit out of niggas and then just go in the store. You know what I'm saying? But sometimes that helps me lower my anxiety because I just have high anxiety at times. You know what I'm saying? I do what I have to do to keep myself focused. That's what I have to do. I just roast the shit out of people. Like, I had to get in some of y'all chats and get the roasting y'all motherfuckers, because one, it helped me out. Number two, I'm going to get on your ass like an untamed lion. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, shit. You been talking shit, and you on here, you build like a rotisserie chicken. You know, you on here, and you look like this and that. You on here, you know what I'm saying? People roast me back, and it's all good. You know what I'm saying? It's all in fun. It's nothing that's malicious. It's all in fun. It's all for laughter, because laughter helps us. That's why we love comedians. You know, my favorite comedians are like Cat Williams, Mike Epps, Corey Holcomb. Those just guys, just three guys off the top, like off the top, that just, when I think about them, it's like, damn, I know when I pull up to a Cat show or Mike show or a Corey Holcomb show, that I'm gonna get some laughter. Like, and it's natural. I like natural laughter. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, man, it's beautiful. Life is beautiful. To be able to live life is beautiful. I think sometimes we take for granted the days that we have. That's why when I make sure I put out content, like even this was so off the cuff, I just like, fuck it, let me go ahead and do it. Because I don't want to leave this earth. I don't know how many breaths I got left. You know what I'm saying? But while I have them, I'm always make sure that I'm putting out some great content I'm happy with. You know what I'm saying? And the outcome is going to be the outcome. And the outcome is going to be the outcome. We're going to keep going from there. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it is, you know. But life is beautiful. And if you don't take the time out to enjoy your life, like before you know it, you'll be gone. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to leave here with people saying, oh, he just was this and that. Like, nah, man, I want people like when I leave here, you know what I'm saying? People say, like, man, that nigga Khalil, boy, that nigga was funny. That nigga always up to something, laughing, debating, roasting, you know what I'm saying? That's what I always want to get across. My mother always told me and my older brother to smile. You know what I'm saying? Smile sometimes. Like, it's all right to smile. I think sometimes, like I said before, you go up in some of these areas, like, it ain't time to smile. You know what I'm saying? You got to keep you. You know what I'm saying? You got to keep your face on, your game face on. But sometimes it's good to smile, man. Like all the time. I try to smile as many times as I can. I try to make people smile as many times as I can because I just cannot be in an environment that's dark and people ain't smiling. Like, nah, don't y'all enjoy life? Like, ain't we been through enough in life? Whatever you done been through, I don't know. But I know for me, I done been through a lot to where a point where it's like, I just want to smile, dog. I just want to be happy. You know what I'm saying? And whatever makes you happy for me is doing shit like that's behind me right here. Like, all this is my art. So I paint. I do this right here. And content. What else? Shit. Play the video game. Have fun with my kids. We have fun. You know what I'm saying? Go outside, sit on the steps and just roast people walking by. You know what I'm saying? Whatever I got to do to have fun and to keep this smile on my face, this handsome smile that my mother and my father gave me, you know what I'm saying? That's what I'm going to do. So, that being said, me, I'm tired as hell. My energy is kind of middling, but I had to put this out because it's important. You know what I'm saying? It's very important that we get together, whether it's for some content or for anything, and we always remember people that have an impact, that have impacted our lives. You know what I'm saying? And we never want to forget, you know what I'm saying, who they are. You know, and I say are because the spirit is still around. You know what I'm saying? That spirit ain't going nowhere, man. You know what I'm saying? Energy, it can never be destroyed. So it's here. With the people who love him, his family, and the fans, like myself, who every year gonna remember 218, 219, his birthday, you know what I'm saying, and how important it is, and what this day means to us, and hopefully what it means to you. You know what I'm saying? So that's all I got to say, man. Y'all know my slogans, man. I don't do too much, man. I love it. Y'all know, man. Make America trill again. You feel what I'm saying, man? Also, man, 988 has been designated as a new three-digit dialing code. Y'all might have seen them on billboards around your city. But 988 is the hotline for that, man. Don't forget that. 988. You gotta put no big ass number, no 1-800. Nah, fuck that shit. Just text, call 988 if you feel like you are in a breaking point. Or even if you don't, even if you just think about something you don't feel well, call 988. If somebody's around you that don't feel well, call 988. I guarantee you, they're gonna put you in the right direction. You know what I'm saying? Also, if you want to donate to this platform, TRILLPILL X is that wrong way. Boom. Right up there. TRILLPILL X is the Cash App. I want to quickly say, I appreciate everybody who has donated to my platform, has supported my platform in any way, whether it was monetary, whether it was through a like or a view. You know what I'm saying? Thank you. Continue to do so. Share it out. I want to continue to do this content. I love doing it. But this content ain't free. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to need some type of currency. You know what I'm saying? Some money, a like, or whatever. You know what I'm saying? To keep this shit going and to put me in the algorithms. You know what I'm saying? I want to stay on beat with the algorithm. You did what I was saying? So, fuck with me, man. Make sure you go follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, wherever you find me. The fan base. I got the fan base up, but all of it is the TRILLPILL. You know what I'm saying? All of it is the TRILLPILL. You know how it is when you're trying to get past a little sickness, a little illness. You know what I'm saying? It's finally getting out of there. You know what I'm saying? It's finally getting out of there. Like I said, man, thank you for watching. I'm not going to ramble on anymore. I want to let you go back and do whatever the fuck you want to do before you see me and see my video. You know what I'm saying? So, much love to y'all. God bless. Y'all know my slowest, man. Monumental to be monumental. Stay true and heal. And most of all, stay mentally real, man. Shout out to all the pretty ladies out there. You feel me? Shout out to all my niggas out there. You know what I'm saying? Stay black. You feel me? Stay black. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? And like you said, man, enjoy life. Smile every day. Fuck what I had got to say. Oh. And before I do this, man. Speaking of fuck what a hater got to say, man. Like I said, shout out to everybody that gives me love. Cause I love love. I'm a person that needs love and affection. And I love when somebody say they love me or they love my content. That is a reflection of me. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate it. But to you niggas who out there who all y'all niggas just say, oh, nigga platform done flopped. You know, that's what niggas were saying about, you know, a year or so ago. Like, we're doing pretty all right. We growing some marathon, baby. Niggas who wish harm on me, harm on my family, harm on anything that I got. Fuck you, nigga. Sincerely. You know what I'm saying, man? Fuck you. But we still gonna get out here and push this line about this mental health. People like you and me. Everybody else that look like me. That's what I'm here for. That's what I'm gonna do. So for all my loved ones, I love y'all. And for all the ones who say, hey man, you a hoe ass nigga or whatever, fuck you, nigga. You know what I'm saying? It's TRILLPILL, man. I love y'all. I'm out this bitch. Solo, whip it.
but my diamonds like a shower. Sipping Momo, going logo, like a logo. Billy man, but I'm thuggin' on a logo. Blowing dodo, ain't about what it, it's a logo. My money, leave my hand and come back like a yo-yo. They on my dick, they throwin' sockets, that's a lover.
That's a lover.
Riding solo, dollar, whipping like a zero.
My bitch a fox, your bitch a thot. You got you just drop, I'm racing my style. I'm punching the clock, I riff when I drop. The grind never stop, I'm riding blue hairs. Pull up at the top, they smile on my face. But really be ops, they stuck in their ways. I'm stuck to the guap, I switched up the plot. And now I'm on top, the bitch is the leader, the cream of the crop. I'm from the bottom, they serving the sauce. The bigger I dream, the harder it got. I never flip, don't know how to fly. I never flip, you don't know how to fly. Custodian nigga, I'm good with the mob. Petroleum blowing, I'm good by the stock. No podium calling the shots up a rock. Plutonium pull up and blow up your spot. I know some niggas that's doing no knocks. Fans on the watch, turned up a notch. Blowing their crops and bleeding the block. These niggas can't walk a mile in my size. They smiling, they plot, trying to take what I got. Ooh, I just wanna put me in box. Ooh, cops wanna put me on lock.
They fuck with these niggas, no trust in these niggas. Ooh, these niggas be switching their sides. See the hate in they eyes, then who I'm with you whenever I ride. No, we not the same, no, we cannot hang. No, you and I gang, can't fuck with no lane. They want the fame, and I want the change. It's all about gangs, I'm moving the chain.
Blame the sisters, they love this world. Blame the ones that they real when they think. Blame the ones that don't give only time. Blame the ones that be moving the stage. Blame the streets that they made me this way. Blame the ones that they real when they think. Blame the ones that don't give only time. Blame the ones that be moving the stage.
Riding solo, dolo, whip it, like I'm swimming. Humble man, but my diamonds like a shower. Sipping Momo, going logo like a Lolo. Billy man, but I'm thugging on a Lolo. Blowing dodo, ain't about what it, it's a logo. My money, leave my hand and come back like a yo-yo. They on my dick, they throwing something, that's a lover.
That's a lover.
Riding solo, dolo, whipping like a Lolo.
The devil is a motherfucking liar. So you know I ain't worried. Bitch. Stupid bitch.